This is Elise Smith's happy place. Put her in any kitchen, anywhere, and she's at home.
I love everything about it.
It all started when she was a child.
Anything that got me to be in a kitchen with my Nana always sounded very ideal, particularly to 7-year-old Elise.
Now 29-year-old Elise has a business, Winnie's Bakery, named after her grandmother, who is also the inspiration for the cookbook she's writing.
I have lists. I always have lists, things I want to do, things I plan to do, and then I really work to try and get them done.
That's because she has to. Elise is sick. The day we met up with her at a culinary classroom in Anne Arundel Community College, she was moving around the kitchen and it was a challenge.
I feel weak and I get bone pain.
She has myelodysplastic syndrome. It's a result of the chemotherapy she had at 18 to treat thyroid cancer.
I got cured status right when I turned like 20, which was amazing. And I was riding that wave for almost a good 10 years.
And now she needs a stem cell donor.
If I don't find a match, I will die.
It's one of the reasons she is doing as much as she can, writing a cookbook, owning a business, and advocating to end childhood hunger as a chef ambassador with No Kid Hungry.
I don't worry so much about dying, but I can't deny that I have so much left that I want to do. And the idea of not being with my family and doing those things at only 29 is rough.
Elise needs to find a donor who is African American in order to get the best transplant outcome. Worldwide, only about 4% of the Be A Match registry is made up of African American donors. She's teamed up with the organization Be A Match, hopeful it will help. There's still so much that she wants to do.
If I were so fortunate to get an opportunity to get this transplant and get better, I don't think there's words in the English language to say thank you enough.
Megan Pringle, WBAL, TV 11 News.